गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑल. इट्स योर क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश. माई सेल्फ कमलनाथ एंड आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द समरी फ्रॉम चैप्टर 5, वेट इन द फॉरेस्ट. यू नो द राइटर ऑफ दिस स्टोरी इज धृति के लहरी चौधरी एंड दिस इज द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द स्टोरी. इन द फर्स्ट वीडियो I had explained you that a young elephant was injured in the forest which was surrounded by a herd of elephants. As its left leg was injured, the elephant was not able to walk properly and it had pain, certainly, as we have pain. The herd of elephants which were surrounding the elephant, they could not do anything. And that's why wherever this herd was seen by the villagers, they had informed the forest division wing, and later on a team was prepared, made so that the team could go explore into the forest and treat the injured part of the leg of that young elephant. So we have already seen that in the team there were 3 members, including even the writer himself was with the team, Dhriti K. Lahari Chaudhary. Although he had not any experience or knowledge about medical hair treatment of a veterinary, but still he joined the team and they had gone to the forest. They tried every means to locate where the elephant was. It was very difficult for them. So let us see what happened in the next part of the story that we will learn today. We will come to know, and I am sure the first video you must have watched and you must have understood what happened in the beginning part of the story. This is the second part, and which is including here the other part of that one. As we know, the team decided to inquire among the villagers when a young man belonging to one of the local tribes said that he knew where the injured elephant was. They were moving from one part to another, but the herd was not seen. As the herd was constantly moving, so it was very difficult for them to locate the elephant and separate the injured elephant from the herd so that they could give the treatment what was needed, in what way they could help the injured elephant. So at last the team decided to inquire among the villagers when a young man who was belonging to one of the local tribes said that he knew where the injured elephant was. He had seen, and that's why he told that he knew where the herd was. Why he knew that? Because he used to feed the elephant as it was unable to move. Many times that young boy had fed that injured elephant because it was not able to move, not able to get its food. So that young boy had just help the injured elephant by giving the food, branches, leaves, whatever the elephant likes only. So he provided, although it was no doubt very difficult because the tribes were suffering due to the elephants. The herds of elephants damaged their crops, destroyed their crops, and that's why that was a problem for them. These elephants were a great problem. But still, in such circumstances, the young boy helped the elephant who was injured, giving food, managing here whatever he could get. So in this way, the team got the help from that young boy who told that he knew where the elephant was. Let us see what happened. The elephants destroyed the crops of the tribal people, as I told you here. But in spite of that, that young boy helped that injured. The team was later joined by a veterinary doctor who had no previous experience of treating injured elephants, tame or wild. Later on, the team that had gone to the forest was joined by a veterinary doctor. And you know what is veterinary doctor? Who treats animals, birds, animals. They are called veterinary doctor. So that doctor also joined that team, but he had not previous much experience about treating injured elephants, either tame or wild. He had experience to treat other animals, birds, but not an elephant. Okay. Next day, the team reached to the spot where there was a group of enthusiastic young men. Next day, that medical team reached to the spot where they saw that there were so many people, so many enthusiastic people, very eager people were standing. The injured elephant was there only, and the team, medical team, who was in search of that elephant, injured elephant, they saw that the elephant was there, and those enthusiastic young men were watching that helpless animal, injured animal. The injured elephant was in the middle of the herd. At that time also, the herd of elephants were surrounding that injured elephant. So when they saw, at that time also, the elephant was surrounded by the injured elephants. So it was impossible to separate it. And as I told you earlier, that elephant took intense care to their teammate, and they could do anything for the sake of protection of their teammate. So it was difficult to separate the injured elephant from the team, from the herd of elephants. Then it was decided to chase the herd so that the injured would lag behind. That will be lag only, not leg, lag, L-A-G, lag behind, and the team would do their work. It was decided that they would chase the elephant, they would make noise, and in this way that would just frighten the elephants, and they would run away. As the injured elephant could not walk so fast, so it was possible for them to separate the injured from the rest of the elephants, and that would be the time that they could treat. So the injured would lag behind and the team would do their work. Okay, there will be lag, my dear. The chase started with making noise and bursting crackers. They got success in their plan. People started making noise, they burst crackers, and the sound of crackers frightened the animals, and so the herd started fleeing from there. They were frightened, and so they started running fast. And in this way, in this plan, the team got success. This idea worked. The herd had fled in fear, and the injured was left behind. The syringe was made ready, syringe injection was to be given to that injured elephant also, because it was not possible, even the elephant was injured, but it was not possible by the team to treat the elephant, because that was wild. The elephant was wild, and that's why the elephant was to be made unconscious. It was to be tranquilized. So the syringe was made ready so that the injured elephant could be tranquilized. And that is what tranquilize, you must know, medicine is given through injection, so that the human beings or even animals could become unconscious, could faint for some short time, so that the treatment could be done. Subrat went forward slowly, fired the gun. It was Subrat only who had to do this. He had only little experience. He was the veterinary doctor. So he made just the syringe, and then threw the gun, that is here, dart gun, especially made that type of gun in which injection is here set, and when they really shoot, that injection just goes far to that particular animal body. It is pricking to the body, and the injection itself is going in the body to make it faint. And so Subrat went forward slowly, fired the gun of injection. The elephant winced little bit here, moved here and there, this way or that way, slightly, and pricked by the dart, it just fell there. It quickened its step. After that, the elephant quickened its step. You can see the elephant is before you, and the leg that is injured, that leg is here, left leg. In that, this elephant had got injury. So the team also quickened their step. When the injection was given to its body, the elephant was a little bit here pained, so it started moving fast. The team also quickened their step to follow. The elephant fell over sideways and lay on its side. So after some time, due to the effect of the injection, the elephant was now becoming unconscious, and after some time it fell sideways and lay on its side, one side. So this was what the way that the team had decided to give injection and make it unconscious. That would only give them time, only sufficient time, so that they could treat the injured part, and they got success in this way. So what happened after that, in what way this team treated the elephant, we will come to know in the next video, last video, and in that one, the chapter, a story will be concluded about the treatment of this injured elephant. We will come to know the way, the last part, in the third video. So till then, hope that you will go through whole chapter once again, as many times you will read, so much better you will be able to understand the chapter. So just I hope that you must have understood this part, and I will again explain you in the online in detail. Thank you, students. Thank you very much.